Hi everybody, today I'll be comparing these two small accessories from Chanel and one from Louis Vuitton. You guys are probably very familiar with these two items as they are very popular within their own brands, especially this key cles from Louis Vuitton. I'm sure you either have one or you've seen somebody with it. I would say that both of these items can serve similar purposes. They both hold plenty of cards, cash, or receipts, but I do prefer one over the other, and I do use one of them almost every single day. So let me just start off with the specifics of these two items. This one is the key cles pochette from Louis Vuitton in the monogram style. When I bought this key cles about 8 years ago, it was only running for about $200. Now, if you try to buy this at the store, it is $325. So that is a significant jump, but it's not too crazy compared to some of the other items. This item from Chanel is the O card holder. And when I bought this item about 6 years ago, it ran for about $400. And I believe if you try to buy this item now in a different color, especially the black one, it's $500. So it's a jump, but from 6 years ago, it's not a crazy jump compared to the classic flat bags. Going on to the sizing, the key cles from Louis Vuitton is a bit wider and it is shorter than the Chanel card holder. And width-wise, I guess width or height-wise, they're about the same. They feel about the same in your hand. As for the number of cards or cash that you can hold, the key cles from Louis Vuitton can hold so much. I have these example cards from many years ago that I just never got a chance to use or throw away. There's about 11 cards and some cash, and you have plenty of space in the key cles. Plenty of space. You could stick probably like, I don't know, 5-6 more in there and you'd still have plenty of space. I love the zipper on the key cles. As you guys all know, Louis Vuitton does zippers so well. They're so smooth, and after using this every single day for 8 years, it's still just as smooth. And just for an FYI, this is an Apple AirTag that I put on my key cles because lately I've been forgetful, and since this item is a bit small, sometimes I lose it. So let's now put some of these cards into the O case. So if I want to put cards into the O case, I can put one in here. Let's see, two. Here's another one in the front. There's two openings in the back. Ooh, it's already getting kind of tight. Let me try putting more in here. It's getting a bit tight. I guess it can fit everything, but it's extremely tight. And then lastly, some cash. Yeah. It's pretty heavy and tight now, and the width is so much more significant than the key cles. And that's because there is some leather in between holding the compartments. There's like this leather inner here. So that just makes the width that much bigger when it is full. As you can see, the width is so much bigger. Also, because this has more leather material that was used to make it, it is very heavy compared to the key cles. Since this is just coated canvas all around, it's extremely light. It just feels like paper. So light when there's nothing in it. My AirTag is probably more heavy than this key cles when it's empty, but this off the bat has weight because of the leather, the green calfskin on this. That's another thing to keep in mind if you want to use this item in a smaller bag, and that's probably what people use this for, right? Because this is not a full-size wallet. It's a smaller SLG, so if you want to use something that can fit in a small bag, honestly, I feel like both can work, but this will definitely fit in smaller bags much more easily. So I brought out my Chanel Mini just for reference to show you what I'm talking about when you're using small leather goods inside a smaller bag. And so when I put my Louis Vuitton key cles and the O card case in there, you can see just right off the bat, even though it's a little dark in there, that the key cles is taking up much less room than the O card holder. Flip it around. As you can see, it's not really taking up a lot of space, or the key cles is not, but the O card holder is. So that's something to keep in mind because these items are, you know, usually used to put into smaller bags if you don't want to carry like a big wallet. And here is the now discontinued, or it has been discontinued for a while, zippy wallet. And so, I mean, you can fit something as large as this in here, but for me personally, I wouldn't want to when I'm using such a small bag, because this wallet is like taking up a lot of real estate, you know? Like, let me try sticking my phone in there now. Let's try. It fits, but this is kind of, I want to put some other stuff in there, like my lip glosses and some tissues, and so this is not going to work. So normally I would use something like this. Now I still have plenty of room to put more stuff in there. And then if I use my card holder from Chanel in here, I still have a good amount of room. But the key clay from Louis Vuitton is still a lot smaller or thinner and doesn't take up as much room. That would be something that I think is a win for the Louis Vuitton key clay over the O card holder because it is so much thinner and lighter. And just for size reference, this is the Zippy Compact Wallet from Louis Vuitton. I mean, this is supposed to be compact and these are definitely smaller. As you can see, and width-wise, so much thinner these two are over the Zippy Compact. And both of these are way lighter than the Zippy Compact Wallet, so they're definitely very, very friendly to carry in small bags. So earlier I mentioned that when I bought these items, this item from Louis Vuitton was only $200 and this was $400. And I'm talking about the price points from pre-price jumps. Nowadays there's a price jump or multiple price jumps every year, and at these price points they were still quite expensive back then. But at that time, comparing these two, there is a $200 price difference between these items. This was $400 and this was $200, and so that's something to consider when you go out to get it, because now this is about $500 and this is $325, so there's still that price gap between them. I think it depends, or it boils down to aesthetics, what you're looking for, and the functionality. I prefer the key clay over the O card case, and that's because of the zipper and also this key holder part, because I use on a daily basis extremely large totes or bags, so my SLGs get lost in the bag. It's just like a tumble, and even though I have a bag organizer, it still kind of just gets lost because I just kind of throw things in there. I'm always on the go, I'm always rushing, so I like having this chain to either latch something onto or find it really easily. And this zipper allows for much more security because you know for sure your cards won't fall out. For this card holder, I feel like it's not as safe. I feel like the cards will fall out over time because this is leather, so it will continue to stretch. So I don't trust that my cards will be safe. You know, these are just giant holes or pockets. You know, they can fall out. And I don't want to risk that because I put my driver's license and all my important cards in these items. And also, I forgot to mention that I use Ski Clay as my main wallet. I put everything that is important that I need in this key clay holder that normally you would put inside of a regular sized wallet such as the Zippy wallet. This used to be my main go-to wallet, but it was too big and too heavy. This is so much more heavy, and it's a little bit empty right now, and it's still very heavy compared to these two, and I have a bad shoulder, so I needed everything in my bags to be much lighter. Like, I can't even use some of my luxury goods, my luxury bags now, because they're just so heavy and my shoulder can't handle anymore. So that's why I downsized to this. And I love this key clay because you can just take it with you anywhere. Put this in your pocket and go walking. I do that a lot when I take my baby for a walk in his stroller. I just take this with me. Sometimes I do put my key in here and just throw it in the stroller and we go walking. And I know that, like I said, because of the zipper, it's extremely safe, whatever's inside. But you can't do that with the O card holder. Or you can, but I just don't think that a key would be safe in here because of the holes, the open holes. I don't think something as small and loose as a key would stay put. I will say though, I do think this O card holder is much more aesthetically pleasing. The O card holder is so beautiful, and that is why I bought it, because it's such a nice pop of color with this cute little Chanel branding, and it's got the quilting, the classic type of quilting that screams Chanel, you know, but it's not super loud because it is an SLG. In my opinion, is like the winner for aesthetics, but functionality and utility and just ease of mind, the key clay is definitely the winner in my book. I use this every single day, and then I actually stop using this item few years ago. It wasn't as functional as the Key Cles. And lately with my baby and everything, I just prefer functionality over aesthetics. But I would say that it doesn't hurt to go for both if you like the look of both and you can find a use for both. I know some people use their Key Cles exclusively for points cards. Old card holder they'll use as their main wallet, which I think is great. And I used to actually do that and throw both of these in my bag. Like, why not, right? You have these two beautiful items, why don't you use them? And I did do that, except it was getting a little confusing because it's sometimes I would think, oh, my card that I'm looking for is in this one, but it turns out it was in here. So I was like rummaging, and when I'm in like a checkout line, I get kind of nervous. I just want to be able to like pull out my card or points card and just move along. So having to look through both, I couldn't keep my head straight in what was in what. So I decided to downsize to only just use one, and then it turns out the Key Cles was much more functional, and so I use this much more. So even though I love the Key Cles so much over the old card holder, I don't regret purchasing the old card holder. I did lightly contemplate selling it, but at the same time, I think it's so beautiful. It's such a perfect piece. There's no flaws whatsoever. So I love looking at it, and it still makes my heart sing. And so I'm really glad that I did purchase it at the time when it was more affordable than it is now. And so I don't regret buying this, even though I hardly use it, and I probably won't sell it because I might use it in the future. Maybe the Key Cles will stop being functional for me in the future because my needs constantly change. Right now, I just really want comfort over aesthetics in what I wear outside. I don't really go for aesthetics over comfort. So right now, this is working best for me, but later, if I just want to like slow down and, you know, look at my items more and use them in a way that I can appreciate them, I think this is something that I would definitely start using again in the future. So I'm really happy to have both, and I highly recommend both. Definitely, I think you will not be disappointed in the functionality of both. Let me know what you guys think too. Are these items still worth it for you? I know these price jumps are so crazy, especially with Chanel, and a lot of people are saying Chanel is no longer worth it, and so I'm really curious to hear what you guys have to say. I haven't bought anything from Chanel or Louis Vuitton in 2-3 years, I think. Maybe even more. It's been so long because there's nothing that I really want from them, and if there is, it's no longer really attainable for me because the only thing I want from Chanel is a classic handbag, and I just don't feel like shelving out $10,000 plus kind of money for that item. I feel like nowadays I'd rather invest it in something that will gain money back because I don't consider luxury goods as an investment type of thing. I don't plan on selling these to make a profit. So let me know your thoughts. There's so many good videos regarding this topic. I would love to hear what you guys have to say, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! By the way, everyone, do you guys remember when Louis Vuitton branding was this beautiful dark chocolate color with this beautiful beige interior? I totally miss this Louis Vuitton branding in this dark brown. I feel like it was so luxurious and it seemed very elegant and understated as opposed to their orange branding. I feel like the orange is a little bit clashing with Hermes's orange, even though they're very different. I just miss this dark color. It was so unique and so Louis Vuitton and so luxurious, but that's just me. Let me know what you guys think. Do you love their orange boxes? Or do you guys prefer this old school Louis Vuitton brown?